The European Union has adopted an innovative new retirement savings tool. What do you need to know about the PEPP, the Pan-European Personal Pension Product? Here's a look.
European policymakers reached an agreement on this project, on this file. So in theory, the legal framework is in place for going forward.
And so what are we looking at happening next? What are the next steps?
Some of the action is shifting to EIOPA. That's the pension regulator in Europe. And they will have to do some, you know, additional implementing steps and regulatory steps, so-called technical standards on a couple of issues.
Anya, as we know from the IRA and the 401k, implementing steps and all those regulations are quite important in how something achieves liftoff. What are you going to be looking after carefully as EIOPA does pick up this work?
The fee cap on the basic option, and also the so-called risk mitigation techniques on the investment options. Each PEP has to come with a basic option. That's a requirement, so every single provider who steps into the space has to incorporate these requirements. And one of the requirements for the basic option is a fee requirement. The fee has to stop at 100 basis points. It's important what will be included in this fee. For example, the PEP has a mandatory advice requirement. So would advice be included in 100 basis points? Will distribution costs be included in this? So we'll be working in, with EIOPA and contributing to their consultation when it comes out on what that means.
ESG rules came into this in the end.
Basically, what they're requiring is that providers have to consider sustainability factors in their investment decisions and in their risk management systems as well. And on ESG, another requirement that is part of the law is that providers have to provide disclosure to investors and whether they took into account and to what extent ESG factors.
You've been working on this issue for years. How do you feel seeing it start to continue to get closer to reality?
The fact that the regulators actually were able to finalize this legislation, put this forward, is extraordinarily accomplishment for Europe. That said, in practice, we have yet to see whether it becomes something that providers can actually offer and people will actually buy.